Over the past few years, various hot and cold therapy methods have grown in popularity. Not as much recently, but I'm sure even the average person has heard about something, whether it's the Wim Hof method and cryotherapy for cold, perhaps saunas and hot yoga for hot. I've answered this in the past briefly. It's kind of like an extra thing to add to your health. Chances are, though, you don't have enough lifestyle factors in check to justify doing these types of activities for their supposed benefits. What I mean by that is the basics. Diet, sleep, radiation reduction, even grounding will offer far more for your health than these two will. Not that they should be disregarded, it's just that most people start obsessing over what more they could do as opposed to correcting what they're already doing. You know, it's kind of like a distraction from your core health, and you want to remove all of the negatives before increasing positives. The thing is, when people think of health in general, it's like, oh, what can I do? What can I eat? It's more about removing the negatives. So most gyms in the United States have saunas, but I believe it's far more popular in Europe, where they use it for pleasure and relaxation, not as much of a health hack. Use of saunas is linked to reduction of various diseases, vascular, high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease, neurocognitive like Alzheimer's, a lower mortality rate overall, even curing ailments such as arthritis and headaches. When you physically go in the sauna, you're stimulating your body's autonomic nervous system, utilizing the processes that regulate blood flow, which actually changes your lipid profile to be more beneficial, as well as lowering your blood pressure. And to simplify that, heat therapy increases blood flow to all parts of your body trying to cool off. And it's usually done from 170 to 212 Fahrenheit, which I believe is 80 to 100 Celsius, for several minutes at a time. Now you got some nut jobs that think more is better. Same with the increasing the positives. No, it's not more is better. You have to be consistent over a long period of time every day, and you'll yield the benefits. And in the winter, those European countries will actually alternate the sauna with like a cold bath. They have a lot of facilities that incorporate both, and it's not like these crazy United States nonsense where they're charging hundreds of dollars for you to do it. So the hot therapy increases blood flow to your extremities, whereas cold therapy restricts it, and your body's using that blood to keep vital parts of your body warm, your organs. More commonly, cold showers are used. Some people like blowing hundreds, if not thousands of dollars on cryotherapy, which to my understanding is, you know, get a nice bath if you want to spend money on something. And when done properly, people notice improvements in immune function, better concentration, higher energy levels, relieving stress, as well as improved sleep. And just like the sauna, this is another way to stimulate your autonomic nervous system. Some athletes are using it to reduce muscle soreness after hard workouts, but I think that's hurting them in the long run. You would want to increase blood flow, not restrict it, when a muscle is trying to heal and recover. But if you have to do like a heart event the next day and you're just getting through pain, that's a different story. However, I don't think cryotherapy, cold therapy should be done on a consistent basis in the context of muscle recovery. I don't see brown fat being talked about a lot, which is what I would assume is, you know, the best benefit. Brown fat being activated when you get cold, but your body can actually create more of it, turning regular fat stores into brown fat if you're exposed to cold frequently. And this brown fat burns more calories, it's thermogenic, it produces heat, and it keeps you warm, requiring far more bodily energy, which is why, you know, our body gets rid of it when it's hot for a long period of time. So we have a general understanding of the extreme ends of these therapies when done actively on a consistent basis. What is missed is that we're supposed to be exposed to these temperatures as the seasons change throughout the year. You know, if we're active outside, our bodies are exposed to intense heat in summer months and intense cold in winter months, regardless of clothing choices, and you're not going to be sitting by a fire all day every day. You have to go out and do things. With modern amenities, air conditioning, heat, sitting around inside all day, comfortable, this has alleviated so much compared to the natural environment. So if you work inside, you don't exercise like the majority of the populace, you will not be receiving the natural seasonal stimulus of your autonomic nervous system, part of your metabolism. So an office worker that starts cryotherapy might start feeling better and noticing a difference, or as a construction worker who's outside all year round has probably never heard of cryotherapy and certainly doesn't need it. So I was kind of doing hot cold therapy a couple of years ago when it was peaking in popularity. You know, I would go outside in the sun in the summer, 95, 100 degrees outside, 15, 20, however long I could take before I felt like I was gonna have a heat stroke. Then I would come inside in the cold shower, cool off, and you know, I would really feel it when I was outside in the sun, when I was inside, the contrast, the different aspects of the autonomic nervous system. Now, I'm actually in the freezer for an hour or two sometimes on a daily basis, and then I don't take those layers off. So I'll have, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 layers on when it's 85, 90 degrees outside. So I'm kind of doing hot cold therapy right now, but it's just so stressful on the body. Like the first thing I do when I come home is I eat and I lay down for a couple hours. You're burning so many calories. You're stressing the nervous system so much. It's just not something that can be done in large amounts on a consistent basis. But if you have everything correct, if you're sleeping enough, if your diet is perfect, and you are like an inside office worker, then you might want to explore intentionally doing this. But you know, just being outside, active, exercising, those are way, way, way more important. So if you don't have everything in check in your diet and lifestyle, I wouldn't bother doing this. And for me, just based off the fact that, you know, I've had a hard time getting proper sleep for the past few years even, I don't bother with this stuff. It just makes it me so much more exhausted and tired with what I'm already dealing with. So hopefully this gives you guys an understanding of this, and maybe you want to try it out, maybe you don't. But if you could please drop a like on the video, leave a comment down below, subscribe so that YouTube can unsubscribe you next week, and be sure to check that notification bell so they don't notify you of my videos. Therefore, you can go to frank-stefano.com to support me through all of my businesses. Thanks again for joining, guys, and I'll see you for tomorrow.